streaming from here?
Also, yeah.
You are a professional. Yeah.
Sorry?
You are really professional. Professional.
Thank you. there a thought that has a meaning, any thought?
There's a thought about meaning.
Is there a, yeah, that would have a meaning, or that
really
says something? No. Because here thoughts seem, I don't know, it's unconscious, the thoughts are unconscious.
Unconscious?
Yeah.
How do you know they're there?
No, I don't know. So there is no knowledge that a thought is there?
There's no...
There is no knowledge or no... that a thought is there, so you...
No, there's no knowledge that a thought is there, but if you ask if a thought is arising, then there's a confirmation that it is, but it doesn't come from any knowing. Okay. That's the difficulty with this. This could say they're sitting on a seat, and that would imply that something knows they're sitting on a seat. In a sense, this can't say at all what's happening because it doesn't know. Mm-hmm. There just is that. Don't even put it into words, they're sitting on a seat. It sounds as though there's something that knows. Mm-hmm.
But how come it says sitting on a seat?
It's just what seems to be happening.
Yeah.
It's what's happening apparently. It has no meaning. Or both. And of course, one has to say that it isn't in time. It is the infinite sitting on the seat. So although you could say that sitting on the seat lasts for 5 seconds or 5 minutes, it doesn't at all. Everything is new. Everything is immediately new. What is? Everything is the infinite, arising and appearing to be happening.
Thank you. For there to be like resonance with this, does there have to be an apparent awakening, apparent like disappearance of the person?
No, resonance is, they can still be a me and they can be resonant.
And different variations is there just because different variations is there?
For no reason.
Or,
no. There's no reason for anything. That's why everything is meaningless, because everything is nothing. Everything is nothing appearing as something simultaneously. So obviously there won't be any reason or purpose to it, because it's not happening.
And if you get that, that's very relaxing, I presume.
Sorry?
And if you get that, that's very relaxing, I presume.
Well, you don't ever get it.
In one interview, that's how I understood it, which I watched on YouTube, just an interview with you on YouTube. You said that, if I understood it correctly, that you don't like go to countries that are far away, like America, for example.
On a especially America.
on a regular basis. Because you said, because you suggest that people attend this quite regularly. That you said in the interview that the reason you don't go to countries that are far away is because you ask or suggest people to come to this quite regularly.
They seem to, yes. And what seems to happen is that we seem to go to Europe and not America.
I thought they were Tony in California on a CD.
I used to go there when I was no younger.
The Tony California CD is like the most brilliant, entertaining like CD.
Oh, that California boy is gorgeous.
Yeah.
But it's something about energy. Like we don't. There doesn't seem to be energy here to go to America or Russia or Australia. There's no reason for that. Well, there is a reason for not going to America, but there isn't a reason. No.
I guess I was confused about, and I get, and again, I might have like, misinterpreted it, like the part about you saying that the interviewer, well, we ask people to attend this quite regularly.
Oh, no, we don't ask anybody to attend it regularly. We notice that they do, but not through their own choice. We do ask a lot of quite a few people, or we suggest to quite a few people, that if they give us half their income, they become enlightened more quickly. It doesn't seem to work. No, there's no, we don't ask anybody to come anywhere. There's no, it just will happen. It will come.
meaning or significance, meditating, seeing lights, those satori experience, does it mean I'm closer to becoming free, or I'm just trying to evaluate my chances?
There is nothing that has any significance or meaning or purpose. And there isn't anything that gets closer to oneness, because all there is oneness. And then we get seeking to get closer to oneness is oneness.
Does that mean that my illusion is falling apart?
That your
and
illusion,
you see the light?
It might be something more solidified, who knows?
So it doesn't mean anything.
There is, what seems to happen is that when people come across this, not through this meeting, but anywhere, when there's an opening to that which is beyond self-seeking, there can be a falling away of the energy of me. But that doesn't mean anything. It could mean that person goes on living in an energy that's less, powerfully mean than it was before for the rest of their lives. Or not.
How to distinguish if that was an imagination?
Sorry, say that again.
How do I know if it was an imagination or something real that points to an experience? Like, I know it's all a dream.
No, you don't know.
Okay.
There's no way.
There's no way to.
All there is what is.
So no significance.
There's nothing significant or important in anything. Because everything is meaningless. So if everything is meaningless, then nothing matters. Is that awful? Somehow also wonderful.
I was kind of proud of those experiences. That's why. I was proud of those. That's why. It's not a relief in a way. I kind of earned them. That's not a few.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
And how can you get nearer to everything?
Nearer to
something. How can me get nearer to everything? All there is everything. So how does something get nearer to everything? There's a movement, so-called non-dual teachers, to do with self-inquiry, and they call it the direct approach. That's the title for. Teaching self-inquiry, but how can you approach everything? How do you approach? Now, the very movement of getting nearer to it, is it already? This mind has some idea that there's something called enlightenment or whatever you like, which you can approach. It's just not. Thank you.
Thank you.